Hashem, today we're going to finish chapter 12 and we're going to cover several final issues in regards to Chalitza. Chalitza, the act of release at the very final stage instead of doing a levirate marriage. There are certain processes that are taking place in the matter of Chalitza, and we're going to touch base on those part of the procedure. We're also going to discuss the Chalitza Mut'ah, which means someone who was misled, and as a result he performed Chalitza with a different intent, while the reality is that when he was aware of the circumstance, he will not perform Chalitza, if this is something that will take an effect or not. Another question that applies not only in the Chalitza but also other matter is the Beit Din, the rabbinic court, can they or does they require to know personally each and every candidate? For example, if it's a matter of a court session between Yavam and Yavama, does the Beit Din require, the rabbinic court need to know personally each one, to identify them, to see in modern days some identification of recognition in order to validate? The same question applies to a matter of mi'un, as we explained, a minor in a very young age, if she was set up and then she have the right of rejection when she reached the age of maturity, is that need, when it's come before the court, if they need to have some sort of a cross-examination, if they need to have a form of identification, or they can just take it in a face value. Another subject we're going to discuss, time allow, is a day kiyum, which means the different form of witnesses. We have witnesses that need to partake of the ceremony. There are witnesses that just need to watch. There are witnesses that need to be the one who was responsible. So we are on page 105, on the very bottom of the page. This is the story of Rabbi Akiva. Maaseh Shechaltzu, we just review what we said yesterday. It's a case of people who are in a jail, and while they are in jail, it was a session of a matter of Chalitza, and it's Rabbi Akiva testified that matter and he approved it. So we ask a question: what exactly happened, how the circumstance took place? And we are just completing the subject of yesterday, page 105, the very bottom of the page. Maaseh Shechaltzu, etc. Ibailu. מעשה שחלצו בינו לבינה אבראי, בא מעשה לפני רבי עקיבא בבית האסורים, מודיעים המעשה שחלצו בינו לבינה בבית האסורים. So the question is, and that's the way Tosfot tells us, is רבי עקיבא partake of that? It just came before him afterward. There is a source in Tractate Brachot, page 61b, that tells that רבי עקיבא was arrested because he taught Torah in public by the Romans. So Tosfot here also have something that it's kind of very interesting. The very end of this Tosfot, he said, "Rabbi Akiva machriz v'amar man bay mechatin u'ma bay tzinurim chalitza b'no lebin amar." So he's like indirectly inform or ask. So in short, "Amar Rabbi Yehuda Amar Rav Beit Asurim Ma'am Asur Beit Asurim Bamase," which means the way that we understand it is. Rabbi Yochanan Sandlar, he is pretend to be a peddler, and he stood outside of the jail that Rabbi Akiva was staying, and he hold a certain item, and he asks question, and indirectly by hearing that, Rabbi Akiva alluded an answer that this matter of Chalitza is valid. So we are now on page 106. Page 106, the Letat Tanu Rabbanan Chalitza Mut'et Kshera. Case like you have Yavam and Yavama. Let's say Reuven Shimon, there are two brothers. Reuven married Tamar, Reuven passed away. Shimon, surviving brother, regular case, she doesn't want to marry him. Can be. So the question is, we want to convince him to release her. So soon you see an example, like offering money, etc., etc. It's like Ellie told me the other day. They have a building. They have tenants that they really want to get rid of. But she's stuck there. And there are some cities, as you know, even some states, you have all those laws that the tenants who stay there for a long time, you have a very hard to evict them. So one of the trick they are doing is they offer money. The management company offered the tenant more money than the rent, paying elsewhere, and compensation just if they're willing to leave. For example, if the tenant pay $1,000 a month, so they said, okay, don't pay us 2 months and take another $1,000 and get out. Right? So in that sense, they try to convince this guy because she refused to marry him, or she's not wished to follow this matter of Yibum, that he should do the Chalitza. So, meaning, you see soon a few examples, they misled him. So the question is that valid or not? Because later on, the guy will find out. Ezri Chalitza Mutel. What do you mean? Amar Yesh Lakish, Kol Shomrim Lo Chalotz Ubekar Chata Chonsa. So, they said to him, guess what? He's not so wise guy. So they said to him, you know, if you perform Chalitza with this person, he think that by doing so, the guy doesn't know much, okay? He doesn't know Yibum, doesn't know Chalitza, doesn't know anything. So they come to him and says, okay, if you do this Chalitza, she can be your wife. So she comes, she take off his shoe, she spit on him, right? They're reading together sentences, he have no clue what he's doing. Now he releases her to marry anybody she wants to. And he think that by doing so, he's going to marry her. So is that kosher? Is that valid or not? So they said, the Reish Lakish said, even it's misleading, he said, by force of circumstance, she's released. So there is a, several, Rabbi Chaim Halevi and others, explanation, what's the idea here? Because if you think about other matter, if it's a matter of money, transaction between parties, this type of thing of misleading information makes the deal invalid, null and void. Or when you're talking about the regular matter of betrothal or divorce, if you don't have this manner of transaction that both parties fully comprehend of what's going on, so it's not in effect. So the rabbis try to tell us that you have to differentiate between something that the person initiating something or something that Hashem commanded us. Here, the Torah tells us that if you're doing certain manner of ritual, the release of Chalitza is in effect. So basically, in that sense, it's a very different school of thought than a regular manner of transaction between two parties. Now, there is another face to that. The guy think if he do that, she will pay him certain amount of money. He's not so familiar. And then after it's all done, she doesn't want to pay him anything. So the truth is she doesn't need to. But in a way, it's a misleading story. Amar le Rabbi Yochanan, Rabbi Yochanan challenged his brother-in-law, Reish Lakish. He says, what are you doing? Ani shone ben shenitkaven velo nitkavnai. Ben shenitkavnai velo nitkavenu chalitzata psula. He says, no matter what, if he's not intending full heart to do it, and she's not intending full heart, it's not, he can't tell me it's kosher. Ad shehitkavnu shneihem ke'echad, until you have both party fully comprehend of what's going on. Ve'at amart chalitzata kshera, and you, Reish Lakish, my chavruta, my brother-in-law, think that it's okay, it's kosher, this type of thing? Ela, he said, כל שאומרים לו חלוץ לה על מנת שייתן לך 200 זוז. So he said to the guy, look, we know that it's a lot of friction between the two. She knows him, let's say Reuven and Shimon. Tamar, the wife of the deceased, she knows her brother-in-law so well, okay? She doesn't want to marry him, right? He wants. So we come to him and says, look, if you do this type of ritual, you get 200 zuz, you get money. So Rashi explained to us, you see in the top, ואף על גב דלא יאהבה לי, even she's not giving him the money. חליצתה קשרה. It's still an effect. כדי מפורש בכתובות בעמדיר, דף עין דלת, דכל תנאי מתנגד בני ראובן, גמרין התנאה שאפשר לנות על ידי שליח, שעשה משה יהושע, שליח לתת להם את ארץ הגלעד. So the Torah tells us that the same way as God made, that Moses made a emissary for these tribes in the eastern part of the Jordan, here, even that it's not the way we wish to, but under this circumstance, it's still taken effect. Tani Namayachi, Chalitza Mut'et Kshira. Ezo hi Chalitza Mut'et. So give me an example of that. So he said, כל שאומרים חלוץ לה על מנת שייתן לך 200 זוז. So it's, if they said to him, okay, you should do חליצה, and on the condition that she will give you 200 dinars. And afterward, when she did not pay, so what happened here? So he said, ומעשה באישה אחת שנפלה לפי אבם שאין הגון לה. And a gula meaning that, for example, he has a blemish in his body, or it's a huge distance in age. Imagine he is at his late 60s, she's at her, let's say, early 40s, for example. Or they don't like each other, she doesn't want him, etc. So he refused to let her go. Imagine the man is close to his 70s, she is at late 30s, right? Their husband, the brother, passed. She doesn't want to marry him. He insisted to marry her. So we convince him, in a sense, he gets this misleading information. Either she pay money or he does this ritual. ואמרו לו, חלוץ לה על מנת שתתן לך 200 זוז. הוא בא מעשה לפני רבי עקיבא והיא כשירה. Even she doesn't need to give him the money. He said, it's kosher, it's okay. Now we have two stories of this type of chalitza mut'et. Ha'ud ha'ata lekamed Rabbi Chiya bar Abba. So this guy wants to do yibum, right? Levirate marriage. Amar la, biti amodi. Said to her, stand and have the... Amra le, ima yeshivata zoya midata. Okay, amar la, yadat le. Do you know there's something that it's bad about him? Amar la, ein. Mamona udechazale. Oh, you know what's happened to this guy? He find out that she's a rich lady. Mm-hmm. And he's not interested in her, he wants to marry her bank account. Right? Vekabai lemech leminei. Who wants to take her money and then divorce her. Amar le lo nichalach. So you don't want to do that. Because he figured out before he's going to fool him, he wants to make sure that she doesn't want him, right? Amra lei lo, I'm not interested in this guy. Amar le chalotz la ubechach ata chonsa. Right? So he said to the guy, do chalitza, and the understanding that the outcome, the guy thought that if he's doing these rituals, he's going to marry her, right? לבטר דחלץ לה, after he did this חליצה, which means they took off the shoe, she spit on them, they read together the lines, etc. etc. אמר לי, השתה מנח, היא פסלה לה. What you do so far, she is prohibited to you, to do yibum. חלוץ לה, חליצה מעל יעתה, כניחד, תשתרה לאלמה. So he said, what you did so far, you release her. Now, I'll tell you what I like you to do now. I want you to do a real chalitza, which means you have now the option to do the something with full intent. And in this manner, she will not be in a limbo because you release her, but we want to make sure that she can go ahead and marry her wherever she wishes to. It's not so simple. The rabbis have a big discussion how the effect takes place and how far you go with this. But this is the second story now. But Chamua de Rav Papa nafla lifnei Yavam she'en agun la. this is again story, painful story, the reality of life, that this lady have the brother-in-law who is really not befitting candidate to spend her life together with him. Atale kamayda abaye, amar le, chalotz la, ubechachat akonsa, the same story. Amar le, Rav Papa, lo sabar, amar le, amar Rabbi Yochanan, that if it's not full intent, it's not effective, echa amar le, eima le, so what do you do? Amar le, chalotz la, al nat shetan lacha 200 zuz. You know what? You do it for the money. She's going to give you 200 zuz. Lebatar de chalitza. And after he performed chalitza, guess what happened? Amar la, zili avle. So he said to her, go and give him the money. So even it wasn't conditioned with receiving the money, Rabbi rules that she needs to give him money. Because she accepted upon herself that if he will do chalitza, she will pay him. So he felt that this is like paying an employee. Mm. Person does something for you, a job, you have to pay. She said, I was fooling you. So that's what she did to him. Mm. So in other words, she never seriously intended to give him the money when accepting his stipulated condition. And even though the chalitza is valid, one cannot force her to pay. Milo Tanya, הרי שהיה בורח מבית הסורים והייתה מעברה לפניו. If someone ran away from jail and he saw a ferryman, הוא אמר לטול דינה ואווירני, if he said, here is the money and you let me cross with the ferry, אמר לו, אין לו אלא שכרו. So, basically, he offered him more money. So, the הלכה is, he needs to give him just the real fare that needs to be paid for that. Alma, amar le, mishatani becha, achana mishatani becha. So you should take it in the same manner that what she said, I was fooling you, and she's therefore exempt from paying the 200 dinars, and abaye akuyas, he agree, amar le, avua, avuch heicha, he said, where is your father? Because he was amazed by Rav Papa's sharpness, mm-hmm. since he was a young man at the time of this incident. So I explained in my book on Rashi. Rashi said that כלומר, כמדומני שיש לך אבאים סמוכים לך לספק צרכיך. So in short, I elaborate here, but the idea is that he was very impressed, especially with this young age and his sharpness. אמר לי במטה, it was in the city, אמך איך, where is your mom? אמר לי במטה. So, יהיב בו עיני ושכיבה. So, unfortunately, yes, the most of the avets and others say that it was kind of ayin hara, but again, there are many explanations what exactly happened. Now, there's another subject, the issue of kavana, of intent. How far you go. Tanu Rabbanan, chalitza mut'et kshira, get mut'et pasul. They misled him, right? So, if a person, for example, give a get to his wife, the bill of divorce, with condition, it's stipulated, in certain things, and that condition is not fulfilled. So the get is not an effective get. But he said, chalitza me'ushet, me'uset, correct chalitza, so he said psula, it's invalid. Get me'ushet, kasher. So the Gemara explained, hechidami, ida amar, if the man, because you force him, רוצה אני, אפילו חליצה נמי. והיא לא אמר, רוצה אני, get נמי לא. So it means that there's no difference between divorce and חליצה. So, אחרי כמה, חליצה מוטעת לעולם כשר, וגט מוטעה לעולם פסול. חליצה מוטעת וגט מוטעה זימין כשר וזימין פסול. אדמה רוצה אני, אדמה לא אמר רוצה אני. It's all different if he's expressed his wishes. נתניה, הקריב אותו. That's the trial beginning of Leviticus. So they said that when a person needs to bring korban olah, מלמד שכופין אותו, he needs to force him to fulfill his obligation to bring the offering. יכול בעל כוחו, תלמוד לומר לרצונו, he needs to express his wishes. הכיצד? כופין אותו עד שיאמר רוצה אני. You put such a pressure that he said I wanted. וכן המוצא בגיטי נשים. So if a husband refused to give his wife the bill of divorce, so what do? כופין אותו עד שיאמר רוצה אני. You go after him, you put the pressure on him, etc. etc. But eventually he said fine. So there is a diyun, there is a discussion among the Rishonim if the Bet Din have to force him. Because there's both in Gemara in Ketubot and Gemara in Bava Kama that said if you have a divri, you have a Hebrew slave, and the period ended, and he refused to leave his master. So basically in a general term you can force him to force him out. So the Netivot, one of the luminary past generation rabbi, have an issue with that. If that means that how a person can force his fellow to do such a thing. The Ketzot HaChoshen said that this is all Isur Lo Taaseh, this is all involved with negative commandment. But when it's come to mitzvot aseh, to the positive commandment, so here it's part of the power of the Bet Din. But today, since we don't have Bet Din Mumchin, we don't have an expert Bet Din, so therefore he cannot exercise any matter of force. Amar Rava, Amar Rav Schora, Amar Ravuna, Cholzim Af Al Pi She'en Mekirim. Next one is the idea of process of chalitza. Is the Bet Din needs to know the people or not? So he said, even they don't know, they can do it. Memanim aval bishel mekirim, the same in miyun. Lefichach, ein kudvin get chalitza. The Edim that sees the chalitza in the form of Bet Din not writes the ketubat get chalitza, ela im ken makirim. Ve'ein כותבים גט מיעוד, אלא אם כן מכירים. So again, we need to make sure that they know the חיישינן, because we are concerned the Bet Din טועים. They don't know what exactly involved in Bet Din. They see a bill that speaks about חליצה או מיעון, and they basically, the second Bet Din, release, which means they take the שטר חליצה, and the person go to another Bet Din, another Bet Din don't know from anything, and they said, okay, we'll take it in the face value and do it. ורבדי דאמר, אין חולצים להם כן מכירים, which means, according to him, you have to know it. Bet Din needs to recognize. ואין ממענים להם כן מכירים. לפיכך, the witness that present there, כותבים גט חליצה, כותבים גט חליצה, רשי said, דים הרואים בחליצה ומיוד אין קודמים ונותנים לה להיות בידה לזכות, אלא כן מכירים שם יוון ויממה. You see, רשי here is very strong. And the next one said, חיישין אנשים עתירי דגת זה לבית דין אחר, וישמחו עליו לא יבדקו עם פלוני זה כתוב בגט. צדור, ואין טוען בהלכה, שנותנים שחוסים ואין זה המענים, אף על פי שאין מכירים. So that's the second בית דין. So therefore you cannot agree on this paper. And then they said, so the Bet Din write get chalitza, and they said, we saw so and so made chalitza, af al pi she'en makirim, v'chotvin megadnu af pi she'en makirim, v'lo cheshen le Bet Din toin. We're not concerned about it. So he, al smach Bet Din, he made this chalitza, he made this mi'un. So we said that the Bet Din need to be very careful, very scrupulous. So we are sure that the first Bet Din are very familiar with the halakha, that you have to recognize the people. Soon you see an example, but the idea is that if it's Yavam and Yavamar, and it's a husband and wife, you have serious manner, very serious. You don't treat it simply. So therefore, you have to recognize them. So the witness that the present that time, they said, we saw the Bet Din put together and have this session of Chalitza or Miun, and we're not concerned the Bet Din does Chalitza without checking who are these people, that this is the Yavam, this is the Yavama, etc. In Gemara and Ketubot, the second tractate of Masechet Ketubot, there is a big discussion over the subject, which is the Kiyum Shtarot. 106b, some word of introduction. The Torah tells us in Deuteronomy 25, V'kar'u lo ziknei iro, the elder of his city. We derive from that the mitzvah of the Yavama to go to the city of the Yavam. Here is the process. Mitzvat Chalitza, Bahu vivimto lebet din. He and the Yavama come to the Bet Din, and the scholars of the court, והן מסיעים לו את צער הוגנת לו, שנאמר וקראו לו זקני עירו ודיברו אליו. There are cases. He is at his, let's say, very old age, right? And she is a very young lady. Let's say if she is at her mid-30s and he is at his mid-70s, right? Mm-hmm. Or vice versa. So we, meaning the people who sit in the court, we try to convince him to release her and not to marry her. We tell him, look, it maybe looks interesting now, but you never know. The way that it's on the surface, it's very... I have a friend, he's a very famous singer in Israel. So after he divorced, he was at his, I think, late 40s or something, and he goes to, from one concert to another, and you know how it works. So it was a young girl at her 19 or 18, who knows, she went crazy after him. And anyway, he married her, and it was the worst mistake he ever made in his life. And the divorce was just beyond awful, because the reality is that it's the distance in values, in age, in mindset, in things. So Bet Din, who was objective and honest, they tried to convince him, get out of this. וקראו לו זקני עירו ודיברו אליו. They need to speak to him. So then they convince him to do Chalitza, to release her. Now, here is the process. והיא אומרת, מאין יבמי להקים לאחיו שם בישראל, לא עבר יבמי. She said that line from the Torah. והוא אומר, לא חפץ לקראתה, I'm not interested in her. ובלשון הקודש היו אומרים, meaning they read, גמרא סוטה 32 said that they have to read from the text, and they need to understand what they are saying. ונגשה יבימתו אליו עיני הזקינים, וחלצה נרו מהרגלו ורקה בפניו. That's the process. It's not part of the psukim, of the verses they said, it's just the process, or how, the Miri explained how the process take place. So roka nir'al adanim, they need to see the speed, right, that she does. V'anta v'amra, kacha yaseh la'ish asher lo yivneh et bet achiv. It's also said in Hebrew, ad kan hayu makrin. So up to this point, they read. Further, they shina, v'kshikra, u'kshikra rabbi huor kanus, tachat ta'ela b'kfar eitam v'gamar et kol ha'parasha. Which means he didn't do just that. He continued with all the phrases for that text in the parasha, which means ונקרא שמו בישראל בית חלוץ הנעל וחזקו להיות גורמים את כל הפרשה. So from that point they don't have to do it, but רבי הורקנוס, since he read it, so they do everything. ונקרא שמו בישראל בית חלוץ הנעל mitzvah ba'anim velo mitzvah ba'tamim. This means we're saying the house of he where his shoe removed applies to the judges, but not to the student of the judges and other onlookers who are present. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, mitzvah al kol ha'omdim shom amar chalutz hanal. It's a mitzvah upon all those present to say he who had his shoe removed. So meaning it's not only upon the dayanim, the judges, it's everyone who's present need to say chalutz hanal. So one of the Torah commentator, his name is Panim Yafot, it's a beautiful commentator on the Parshat Ki Tiseh, this portion in the Deuteronomy. He said that for every single mitzvah, in our anthropomorphic language, it creates malach, it creates a heavenly entity. So it can be the other way around too, via negativa. So he said, Be'idna deritcha, when it's a time that it's a heavenly judgment, that entity can create damage. So this fellow is not merited to have children. The only substitute is by having this Yibum. And now it's considering that he's not left any child because he's not wished to do Yibum. That's a problem. So the Malach can do damage to him. So here he explained that's the reason when he have a lot of bizayon, he had a lot of embarrassment. So he does that in Hebrew, and Malachi HaKodesh understand that, and therefore they leave him alone and not go after him. That's the Panim Yafot on Parashat Ki Titzeh. Now we go in very short term how the Chalitza taking place. Amar Rav Yehuda, Mitzvat Chalitza Kora VeKore VeCholetzet VeRokeka VeKora. Rav Yehuda said the correct order of the mitzvah of chalitza is she recites the sentence beginning with my brother-in-law refused, and afterward he recites that not wish to take her, and then she removed the shoe and spit at the brother's house. So that's the way they do it. All the psukim mentioned here. Now, Rashi said that it has to be this way. Anyway, Maika Rashmanan, that's we already studied in Mishnah. So he said, Madnitini, Akamashman mitzvah hachei, that's the chachila, viyapech litlen. If someone did not the right order, for example, if she spit before she take his shoe, so Meiri said, any type of this, it's fine. So Akamashman, the mitzvah hachei, mitzvah lechachila. To do it. We don't care the order. Tanya Nameach, Ben Shekdim Chalitza Lerkika, Ben Shekdim Rika Lechalitza, Ma Shasa Asui. Which means, at the first place, we don't wish that. But if it happens that he did first Rekika and then Chalitza, or first Chalitza and then Rekika, in a sense, we have a regular order, but he mix up the order. So as long as he did it, he did it. Omar Abaye, high mind the makri, the one who read to a woman those verses, those psukim, get chalitza, from that get, lo likre ledida, lo lechudei, ve'avai abmi lechudei, the mashma, avai abmi, because it may be easily misconstrued that you wish to go ahead. And the truth is the opposite. Ela, לא אביי אבני ולא לקרא לדידי he is doing it in one shot לא לחודי חפסתי לחודי דמשמע חפסתי לקחתה אלא לא חפסתי לקחתה. So it's like listen carefully to that line. That's the view of Abaye. אמר רבא disputed, said אפסוקי מילתא היא ואפסוקי מילתא ליתלן בא. So, meaning, even he made a hafsaka, a stop between the words, the mitzvah fulfilled kehilchata. Story. Rav Ashi, Ashkechel Rav Kahana, dika mitzta'er umakrila lo avai abmi. He make an arduous effort to make sure she said it in one breath. Amar le lo sabar ma'ala ade rava. There is a concept in Hebrew, you call it רצוי and מצוי, meaning there's something that you wish to and something that you have to face reality, right? So people, how they can say it in certain way, אמר לי מודה רבה בלא אהבה יבני. So I explained in my book at length, Rashi here said the bainan shlo yafsik etzelo etzelo, klomar lo me'en ela ava yabni. So I brought here the Rif and the Rosh and the Rashba etzelo, that if you read it in very very short, because running out of time, if you read it in a very it can be in a reverse order, in a reverse understanding. So you're welcome to read it, it's a lot, but the idea is that Rava agreed that she needs to do it in one breath, and that's the reason why I make an extra effort, because that's the way it should be done. Amar Abayi, Haiman dechatav gita dechalitzata לכתובה חקרינו לדידה מן מאל יבמי עד אבמי, וקרינו לדידי מן לא עד לכתב, וקרינו לדידה מן ככה ועד חלוץ הנעל. Meaning that's the line of the psukim they need to say. מרזותה מסרטט וחתיב לכול הפרשה. He just put it in writing and make sure that they said right. מר תקיף לה מר בר אידי והלו ניתן לי כתב. You don't write the line from the Torah itself. והילך דקבטי דמרזותה. That you can do it, meaning you can use a klaf mesurtat on get chalitza. Mar abayi rak kawul datato aruach. So it spit and it flew with the air. Lo asta velo chlum, nothing. Ma itama v'yarka befanav ba'inan. The Torah said to Deuteronomy 25 that she needs to do it in front of him. Hilkach, hu aruach v'hi gutza. He is a tall man and she is small. Uklatat hu aruach, ikra befanav. So ika befanav, he arukav v'hu gutz, she is playing basketball and he is a midget, right? Yes. Right? Bina matel ade ape v'ada razil. Phew! Lifted up, right? Anyway. Amar Rava, achla tuma v'rakta, if she ate garlic and she spit, achla gargishta v'rakta, lo asta v'lo klumai. Tama v'yarka me'atzma b'inan v'leika. Meaning that has to be a natural way. ואמר רבא צריכי דנה למח זרוקה כנפיק מפול מדיע, ואמר דכתיב דנה הזקנים בירכה. זה תורה says clearly that need to be appear at the eye of the scholars in the court. ונקרא שמו בישראל בית חלוץ הנעל. So they said and his name should be called in Israel the house of one who has shoe removed. So they said מצווה בדיינים ולא בתלמידים. The מצווה upon the judges to recite this, but it's not requirement for the students or onlookers. Tanya amar Rabbi Yehuda, pam achat hayinu yoshvim bifnei Rabbi Tarfon, ubaata yevama lachalotz. The story that happened, so the yevama came to perform chalitza. Ve'amar lanu, Rabbi Tarfon said to everyone, anu kulchem, you must all answer, chalutz hanal, chalutz hanal, chalutz hanal. Three times, he who had his shoe removed. So it's stating that portion of the verse three times. So that's the even in our Gersa it's once, here they said three. So Halachot Gedolot said because the reason it's like he's a mourner, like he's excommunicated. So there's they say the three times. One is like a mourner, one is like menudeh, someone who's in a ban, and in a way it's like the third one that is like a punishment that he rejected a mitzvah that was given on Sinai. Yamshe Shlomo said it's just to strengthen the bedin view, but there are those who say that even the yevama need to say three times chalutz hanal, and the dayanim needs to repeat it. That's the again there is a different views. Yamshe Shlomo, Shulchan Aruch, etc., Hadran Alach, מצוות חליצה.
בויחם לשולוים מלאכי השולוים מלאכי